Let's talk about bevels. To make a bevel, press tab to go into edit mode and control B will create your bevel. Now, have you ever had the issue where you do control B and the bevel just seems to be extending a little bit too long? What's happened is your scale is off in object mode. So press tab to go back into object mode. And if we press N and look at our transform, we can see our X scale is off. All we have to do is go control A and apply the scale. So when we come ahead and do it on the other side, control B, we can see that it's more uniform. Now with the plane, control B does not work. To bevel a vertice, you got to press control shift B, and then you can go to town. Another thing you can do with bevels is control B, give it some bevel, and then use the mouse wheel to give it more bevels. Sometimes you might have the issue where you go control B, and then they kind of overlap and it just kind of goes all yuck. What you can do is select your bevel, come down into the bevel in the bottom left, and enable clamp overlap. What this will do is stop any bevels overlapping each other. Now there's other cool little things that I do with bevels. With some of my sci-fi panels, I go control R to add in an edge loop and then right click to recenter it. Control B to bevel, and that gives me a little bit of extra data. What I will then is control B again to add another little bevel, and then I'll select these two edges, scale along the y-axis, and we've kind of got little insets. So with everything we've learned, we can actually take this and create some sci-fi panels. Kind of like these ones, which are part of my kitbashing set. From here, what you can do is you can grab these panels, and by using the shrink wrap modifier and the project, we can send these types of panels straight onto ships to create some sci-fi paneling.